looked at the ceiling of his bedroom and said to himself, what I love in this world, in this life, is God, my farm, and my family. And on his farm, he had some cows, he had some cows, he had some cows, he had some chickens, he had ducks, he had some very small barking dogs, little tiny 1-inch long dogs that had red stripes all over them, and they lived mostly on the farmer's shoulder. And then he woke up in the morning and go,
hello, good morning, hi, how are you, good morning, hi.
And he had a dog, and he also had the strange and unusual beast called the yak. And one day, and verily, as the man was surveying the beauty of his land, of his home, of the place where he lived, he said, with a smile on his face, he said to himself, my life has been good to me. And all the animals on the farm went, yes. He walked down off the porch, and he noticed that a rake was facing the wrong way up. A rake could be very dangerous to his young children when they came home from school, and he must remember to fix that rake. And he also walked past 5 hoes.
Oh, oh, oh.
He walked up onto the hill, up onto the grassy knoll where President Kennedy was shot, and he could see off yonder, off in the distance, that the yak, who was tied to a chain to a tree, was acting strange. The yak was moving its head from side to side. The yak was making horrifying noises. The yak was going, rah, 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 rah. And the farmer cut close to me and said, what's wrong? What's wrong? What could be wrong with the yak? And the yak said, I'm sick, you stupid farmer! I'm burning up with fever! So the yak was acting terrifying, and the farmer moved closely to the yak because he was afraid of the yak, because the yak had bit him one time. And so he moved up closely, and he put his hand on the yak's forehead, and the yak was going, rawr, rawr, rawr! And he could feel that the yak was burning up with fever, and it terrified the man. Down the hill past all the animals, who all looked nervous about the situation that was happening, and first came up to the porch, and he burst into the kitchen, and he said to his wife, who was beautiful and fair, he said, the yak is sick, the yak is sick, the yak is burning up with fever, the yak is sick, ah! And his wife, as always, put her hands on his shoulder and said, calm down, be calm, just be calm, the yak is sick, the yak has a fever, just feed the yak. Give the yak some toast. Give the yak some here. Give some of this oatmeal here, and give it some raisinettes and some pork chops from last night. And she so laden the man there with food that he could not see where he was going. But he knew the path, and he walked out the kitchen door backwards. And he came down the stairs, and he walked, and he stepped on the rake that was going the wrong way up. And the rake came up and hit him in the head, and he died immediately. And the moral of the story is, feed a fever. Star of the Yak.